day. You scare my friends away. Why are you haunting me? You fly around my room. You rattle chains till three. When I turn out the light, you're in my bed at night. Why are you haunting me? I have the letter you left me the night you took your own life. You said you'd come back to get me, and I don't stand a ghost of a chance tonight.
Welcome to another edition of the DNN.
Yes, yes, yes. It's your boy Raleigh.
And this is Ryan. Now we're going to go to a special guest announcement with our two candidates for the presidential election,
Al Gore
and Joe Lieberman.
Right.
How's it going, Joe?
Hey, how's it going, Al? How's it going?
And today is October 31st, 2000.
Halloween.
Yes, it's
Halloween. Boom! I know. I'm scared.
All right. Well, did you see that Monday Night Football game last night?
Yes.
Well, the Redskins lost. And when the Redskins lose their final home game before the presidential election, it's bad news for the incumbent.
That's us!
Yes. We have not won the election. Said nobody has won the election after losing that football game in 40 years. All right. Hey, you know we gotta get down to Florida.
Yeah, the campaign. Come on, let's get Miami. Let's go. We can win it.
No, we gotta go down to Orlando and pick up Bill McCollum and take him to the TD Waterhouse Center for that NSYNC concert.
NSYNC! Let's run!
Yes, I know it was a surprise.
Run!
I know it's a surprise.
Run!
We gotta go. We gotta go get there.
Gotta get a ticket. Right. Run!
And on the way, we're gonna have to pick up a birthday present for Vanilla Ice.
Oh, it's his birthday again?
Well, I know, but I thought he was dead too, but come on.
No, wait. That was his career.
Oh, so what are you and Hadassah gonna do for Halloween?
Well, I was thinking about dressing up like Dick Cheney.
Dick Cheney?
Yeah.
That's scary. Pretty scary.
That's scary.
I was gonna take the bolts out of my neck and be Al Gore.
Stop pointing at me.
I'll point at you whenever I want.
Know why?
Because I feel your pain.
I feel my pain. I'm the man.
All right, now back to me.
Back to me.
Senior, senior, seniors, did you forget your order, your graduation announcements? How would you let everyone know about your great achievements? Would you like a mailbox filled with checks? If the answer of any of those is questions, of any of those questions are yes, then bring your order form and deposit to the Bank Commons on Wednesday, November 1st, during either lunch shift. Justin will return for one last order day. Extra order forms can be picked up in room 606. Thanks. Remember, see the complete works of William Shakespeare, November 15, 16, 17. And now to Hispanic Day video.
Heavy smoker.
As you heard, I'm Mrs. Pagan, and here for the first time we're going to celebrate our Latino diversity that we have at Apopka High School. This is the month of Spanish awareness or Hispanic awareness in the United States, and we decided to have today a buffet. We're also having a show that made by students for students. We're having piñatas, actually painting on the hand or arms, and I believe we're also going to have some crafts. So we're really looking forward to this, and I just wanted to know that we're great people and we are here just to celebrate and also be proud of being American.
All right, there will be a mandatory club dub meeting Tuesday, October 31st at 2:15 in room 135. Be prompt.
All right, remember to go see the complete works of William Shakespeare November 15th, 16th, and 17th. Tickets are $5. The regular tickets are $8 each, I believe, for the reserve tickets. And those will be sold during lunch until we sell out. So go get them early, all right?
I think now we get to go check with our field reporters, Natalie and Sean. I think they're out in the field with some new headlines on news. Let's go take a look.
Oh my gosh, I can't believe we skipped Scales class.
Yeah, that's great.
Yeah, I sure do think this Apopka force is very odd.
It's kind of ghetto. It's kind of small.
What the... What's that noise? Oh my gosh.
Oh my gosh. I heard something.
I don't know.
Ah! Ow!
Oh my god! What is it?
It's a dead bear.
Oh my god.
It's a dead bear.
It's Smokey.
Is it still alive?
No, I don't think so.
Want to poke that?
Nope, he's not alive.
No way. Hey, it's Halloween. Why don't we, do a seance or something? That'd be kind of cool.
That could work. I guess we could do that.
Okay, let's try to make him come alive.
Here we go.
Let me get a stick. Alright. It's not working.
Hiya, karate chop. I guess it didn't work.
Let's do dance. Okay. Yeah, this isn't working. No way.
Maybe next year.
Yeah, he's kind of...
Oh my gosh! Run! Oh my god! I'm gonna cry!
Oh my god!
Get back up! Hurry! Get back! He's coming! He's eating you! Oh my god! Oh my gosh!
Oh my god!
Oh my god! I think we lost him.
Let's go!
I'm pretty sure we lost him.
Let's go! Oh my gosh.
I don't see him.
I think we lost him.
Oh my god, I think I see him. There he is.
Oh god,
I'm gonna hit him.
Oh my god,
oh my god, there he is.
No, move,
bear.
Move,
I gotcha.
Oh my god.
Get back in the car. Get back in the car. Get up, you dummy. Oh my gosh.
Go.
Oh, it's stuck. Oh my god.
Oh my god.
Oh my god. Oh man, I can't believe that happened.
I think we lost him. Never checked.
Well, you know what? I think that we should stay in school.
Yeah, stay in school, guys. That teaches you.
Yeah. Doot 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 doot. Hey, you're not supposed to be here. The end.
Exorcist game.
Yeah, we're glad you guys are okay, and that's too bad about JJ. All seniors and juniors who wish to take the ACT on December 9th are reminded to stop by the guidance office to pick up a registration form. The deadline for registration is November 3rd. Any student interested in wrestling? Official wrestling practice will start today at 4. And now to video.
Supertones, let's rock! We'll be right back.
overflow on the underground scene.
There will be a mandatory Club Dove Pride meeting on Tuesday, October 31st at 2:15 in room 135. Please be prompt. Attention Shakespeare class. Everyone must be at rehearsal on Wednesday after school at 3 o'clock sharp. Do not be late. And now to a Freshman of the Week video.
His personality began
to... Well, that's all the time we have for today. Hope you guys had a nice, enjoyed the broadcast and everything.
Yeah.
So
it was all right.
We'll see you guys Friday.
All right.
All right. Then.
Oh, no.
In the name of the Father and of the Son.
Welcome to the special Veterans Day edition of the DNN.
Good morning, Apopka. Your Blue Darter JROTC unit is proud to present this special edition of the DNN in honor of two very historic days in America. First, on this day, November 10th, 1775, the Continental Congress declared that two battalions of Marines be formed to fight in the Revolutionary War against Great Britain. These two battalions eventually grew into the United States Marine Corps, which today celebrates its 225th birthday. Secondly, tomorrow, November 11th marks the commemoration of the end of the Great World War I, once called the War to End All Wars. Originally known as Armistice Day to remember the sacrifices of the First World War, the holiday was officially changed in June of 1954. President Dwight D. Eisenhower signed a proclamation changing Armistice Day to become Veterans Day in honor of all the veterans who have bravely served our country in all its wars from 1775 till today. And so it is that we wish to salute all America's veterans on this special day. The following members of Apopka High School's faculty have served in our armed forces: Mr. Hicks, 20 years in the U.S. Navy; Mr. Worthington, U.S. Air Force; Mr. Burke, U.S. Air Force; Mr. Stroud, U.S. Air Force; Mr. Locke, U.S. Army; Mr. Howard, U.S. Navy; Mr. Camp, U.S. Army; Mr. Booth, U.S. Marine Corps; Mr. Hogan, U.S. Army; Chief Warrant Officer Jack Wing, U.S. Marine Corps; Master Gunnery Sergeant Seward, U.S. Marine Corps; First Sergeant Dreyer, U.S. Marine Corps; and Colonel Samolin, U.S. Marine Corps. And now to Juan.
Attention, Lion Club members, there will be an important meeting Thursday, November 16th, from 2 to 3, in room 306 on the main campus. Snacks will be provided, but bring your own drinks. To all junior class council members, there will be a meeting Wednesday, November 15th. All members must attend. And now to a weather video.
Today is November 10th, and the weather is brought to you by James
and Michelle.
And now, up here is bathing suit. Down here is not bathing suit. No. Now see, this is bathing suit. This is not bathing suit. Oh, today is November 10th, and the weather is brought to you by James.
And Michelle.
Now, this up here is sweater, because it's cold. And down here is bathing suit, because it's still hot. And that's your weather.
Attention all Florida future educators. All members need to turn in their candy money immediately and pick up more candy. All candy must be sold by the end of next week. Everyone needs to sell their fair share. See Mrs. Bolton immediately. Attention sophomore class council. Meeting Thursday, November 16th. Room Science 118 at 2 p.m. till 3 p.m. Be there. The canned food drive began today in fourth period classes. It runs through November 17th. The students and or classes with the most cans will get to attend the Winter Sports Assembly on November 22nd. Those competing in the box decorating contest will be judged on Friday during fifth period. And now back to Maine.
The National Honor Society will be having a meeting on Monday, November 13th after school.
Remember to go see the complete works of William Shakespeare. Tickets are now on sale.
There will be a senior class council meeting on Friday, November 10th, directly after school. Please be there. Thanks. And now to Juan.
Now we go to a Veterans Day interview video.
Hi, I'm here with Joe Navarro, and I'm asking people, what does Veterans Day mean to them? So what does Veterans Day mean to you?
Well, Clark, Veterans Day to me means a time for America to look back and thank all those who served our country.
Thanks. Hi, I'm here with Mr. Swift. What does Veterans Day mean to you, Mr. Swift?
Veterans Day means to me that it's honoring our American soldiers, our soldiers that died in the war, and wars for and fight for our country, people that really served our country, and
All right, thanks.
By Mr. Kemp, chemistry teacher, we're asking him, what do you think Veterans Day means to you?
Veterans Day to me is a time for honoring our veterans and also the ones that have died for our country in the past years to keep us the great nation that we are today.
Mr. Harrison, we're asking him, what does Veterans Day mean to him?
Veterans Day to me is a day of remembrance where we think about the sacrifice that millions of Americans have made through our military efforts to preserve our freedom and our liberties in our country. And it's a day to honor them.
Nino, this has been all for the interviews for Veterans Day, but it is important for us to remember that all these men and women have made the ultimate sacrifice and gone to war for us so we can live in a free country. And I think we should all remember that and be thankful for their sacrifice. That's all. For the DNN, thank you.
This has been all for the DNN today. I'm Clark, and this is Ryan, along with Juan and Jillian. Thanks for watching. Don't forget to come out tonight and watch your daughters play. It's going to be great. We're going to close now with a ceremony performed for fallen veterans. Thank you.
Mrs. Bobble teaches listening. Miss Wobble teaches smelling. Miss Fibble teaches laughing. And Miss Quibble teaches yelling. What's up, y'all? This is Raleigh Stewart, and I'm here reading one of my favorite books, Dr. Seuss's Hooray for Diff and Do Day. Check it out.
Come
on. All right, I'm here with Coach Darlington. He's going to tell us his favorite book.
Well, this book here is about a pig and a pancake. That's not my favorite book. My favorite book is called The Big Bad Pig and the Three Little Wolves. There were these three cuddly little wolves, and their mama sent them out in the world to go ahead and make a life for themselves. So they went out and they built a house. They built it out of brick. And down the road came the big bad pig. And he huffed and he puffed and he tried to blow their house down, but you know, they weren't having that. So what did he do? He took a sledgehammer and he destroyed the house.
My favorite book is The Missing Piece by Shel Silverstein. It's a very great adventurous book about a not quite yet circle trying to find its missing piece. He goes through all things and all troubles just to get this missing piece. Now, to find out if he really does get that missing piece, you're just going to have to check this book out.
Remember to have a wonderful Thanksgiving holiday.
And eat lots of turkey.
This has been Off the DNN. This is Stephanie.
And I'm Dara.
And now we're going to close with a video on the Apopka High School singers going to the Macy's Day Thanksgiving Parade.
Good morning, Apopka High School. I'm Mrs. Boot, and I'm the choral director here. And we're very excited about our special opportunity to go to New York City and perform in the Macy's Thanksgiving Parade. We'll be leaving Tuesday morning at 7 a.m. And while we're in the city, we will be rehearsing. We will also be doing a service project. We'll be making sandwiches for the New York soup kitchens. And we will get to see a Broadway musical. We're going to see Kiss Me, Kate. We're also going to see the Radio City Christmas production. And of course, we're going to perform in the parade. So please watch Thursday morning, 9 a.m., NBC. Have a great Thanksgiving.
I'm Howard and I'm in Apopka Singers, and I have to say I'm just so excited about going. I've never been to New York, and this is going to be such a great experience for all of us.
Hi, I'm Rachel.
I'm Kristen.
I'm Lauren.
And I'm really excited about going to New York City because I've never been there before, and I hope it lives up to everything I've heard about it.
I'm really excited just to be in the Macy's Day Thanksgiving Parade and to be representing Apopka.
And it's going
to
be a great opportunity for all of us.
And then are you going to do anything?
Hey guys, it's the Apopka Singer guys, and we're just telling you guys to Thanksgiving morning, Thursday morning, come watch us at NBC at 9 a.m. We're going to be on. You'll see us in bright colored sweatshirts, and we're going to be dancing and singing, and you'll probably see one of us on, so make sure you watch.
The DNN would really like to congratulate Mrs. Boot and those kids from Apopka that are going to New York. They're going to sing in the Macy's Thanksgiving Day Parade. It's a real exciting adventure. Channel 2 News was out here the other day, and they filmed the bunch getting ready to go, and that story is going to air Wednesday at either the 5, 5:30, or 6 o'clock news, so be watching for that. And it will also air right before the parade on NBC Thursday morning at 9 o'clock. Don't miss it. And now we'd like to show you a brief film clip of last year's parade. And this was the bunch that sang last year at last year's Thanksgiving Day Parade. So, watch for it this year, and instead of those old folks, you're going to see kids from Apopka. Again, the DNN says congratulations and have a great time in New York.
welcome to another edition of the DNN. I'm Jillian.
And I'm Christian.
And now to the two kings of Zamunda, Ryan and Raleigh.
Good morning, Apopka.
Kilele, kilele, awa, awa, kilele.
Good morning, Apopka. Hello. Today is the 332nd day of the year 2000. There are 23 days left to the end of the year.
Okay, also in history, our great-great-grandfather, Eddie Murphy, King of Zamunda, Hakim, he found his wife in America.
In Brooklyn and Queens.
Yes, it is. Yes,
tell them about Al Sharpton.
Oh, yes. Also in the news today, Al Sharpton went to Cuba and talked to Fidel Castro about holding a stage hip-hop concert.
Hip-hop.
And we love hip-hop. Jump around. Jump around.
Jump up, jump up, and get down. Go.
Jump around.
Go.
Jump around.
Okay, okay, okay. Sorry. Also, nowadays, the minorities are giving back to the community. Ooh. Yes, today, in the newspaper, I saw it today.
Today.
People gave $10,000 to college for today. Today.
Today.
Minorities are starting to give back to community. Big
ups. Hallelujah.
Big ups. Big ups.
Big ups.
Oh, king, props. King. Fly.
Oh.
And now, to Michelle.
Lots of horseflies.
Santagrams, 50 cents for 50 words. You can put a holiday greeting for a friend in the next edition of the Darter Times. Over 50 words, it's a dollar. This is an easy way to send a holiday cheer to a buddy. Simply find a member of the Darter Times or go to room 127 where you can leave either a sheet of paper with a message on it or an IBM formatted disk. Happy holidays. And now to a Just Read video.
Beers, written by Tom Clancy. It's a good book by a guy who flies a plane, saves some lives. Not that big, couple day reader.
Hi, my favorite book is The Holy Bible. I'm Mrs. Leonard, and the reason it is my favorite because it gives instructions for life.
Congratulations to the men's soccer team for a 3-0 victory over Tavares High School. Goals were scored by senior Carlos Alvarado and sophomores David Culp and Ryan Simmons. Assists were recorded by Mark Galarte. The next game for the Blue Darters men's soccer team will be the district opener against the Evans Trojans this Wednesday at Evans.
All girls who plan to attend or try out for the fast pitch football softball team need to see Coach Morgan in the ninth grade campus or stop by the softball field after school and see Coach McWithy. Conditioning for softball begins today, Monday, November 27th, after school on the softball field.
Attention students planning to go on the 2002 Italy trip. All money and unsold candy must be turned in by this Friday, December 1st. Also, you must sign up for the bake sale shifts by this Friday, December 1st.
Attention National Art Honor Society members, don't forget the Gingerbread House competition this Thursday in room 406. After displaying them in the media center, they will go to Anthony's house.
And now to James.
My favorite book is Stephen King's The Dark Tower. It's a pretty good book, and I think you should check it out. Hi, I'm Adam Lott. I'm here with Miss Dunn. Now, Miss Dunn, what's your favorite book?
I have to say The Hot Zone is one of my favorites.
And why is that?
Well, it's pretty relevant to today. There's Ebola outbreaks in Africa going on, and there's a lot of new research being done on viruses and bacteria. And especially being a science teacher, this is really a fun book to me.
All right, thank you, Miss Dunn.
There will be a mandatory meeting of those people interested in forensics on Friday after school in Portable 16 on the 9th grade campus. You must attend in order to complete this year in forensics. Final yearbook sales November 27th through December 1st. Cost is $50 and sold during lunch on both campuses. Senior ads available until December 1st. Full color $275. Half page $180. And not a driver's ed video.
kilele, kilele, awo, awo, kilele.
We are back.
Yes, we are back.
Freshmen. Yes, freshmen. Pay attention. You must graduate high school. Yes. And yes. Right now, there is 63% of you who cannot graduate. That is 63%.
Ooh, that's
that is
low.
Very, very bad.
Very low.
Very bad.
No.
Very bad.
No.
And sometimes we like to joke and play, but yes. Right now we know joke and play.
No joke.
63% is very, very low.
You need a 2.0.
2.0 to graduate.
1.9, 1.8.
No, no.
2.0.
Also, remember your candy grams, because candy is very good.
Yes.
Go buy them from wholesome members.
Yes.
Candy grams very, very
and
good.
And also, we sell Nashville horse fly swatters in back comments today.
Yes.
For $2,000. Not $2, or that is 3 African pesetas.
Yep.
Okay? Yes. Yes. You like fly swatter? Okay.
Okay.
Yes.
Now back to people.
Bye.
That's an all for the DNN today. Have a good day. Bye.
Bye.
Kilele, kilele, agwa, agwa, kilele. Good morning, Apopka. I am Prince of Zamunda.
I am Prince of Zamunda.
My son.
Yes, yes.
Okay, and now to video headlines, okay?
Yes, yes, yes.
Okay.
You have 24 more shopping days until Christmas.
Stay in history. In 1913, the first drive-in automobile service station opened in Pittsburgh. In 1955, Rosa Parks refused to give up her seat on a Montgomery City bus. She was arrested, sparking a year-long boycott of buses by blacks. In 1969, the U.S. government held its first draft lottery since World War II.
Today in headlines, more than 36 million people worldwide are now living with AIDS or the virus that causes it.
The U.S. Supreme Court is scheduled to begin hearing 90 minutes of arguments at 10 a.m. this morning in Bush versus Palm Beach County. As the temperatures drop towards freezing, 200 or so people hoping to witness history in the making hunkered down against chilly December wind outside the Supreme Court. Some say it was more like a rock concert than a hearing.
And now off politics and on to more important things.
The TV remote is 50 years old, so all you couch potatoes, time to bust out them party hats.
Oh yeah, Bette Midler's 55.
Last night, the Lady Darter soccer team beat University 1-0 in a very hard-fight Metro Conference game. Jessica Cooley broke a scoreless game by scoring on a direct kick halfway through the second half. There will be a mandatory meeting of those people interested in forensics on Friday after school in Portable 16 on the 9th grade campus. You must attend in order to compete this year in forensics. Santagrams, 50 cents for 50 words. You can put a holiday greeting for a friend in the next edition of the Darter Times. Over 50 words, it's a dollar. This is an easy way to send holiday cheer to a buddy. Simply find a member of the Darter Times or go to room 127 where you can leave either a sheet of paper with your message on it or an IBM formatted disk.
All right, attention, today is the last day to buy a yearbook. Yearbooks are $50 and sold at lunch on campuses. Also, today is the last day for senior ads. If you're rich, full color is $275, half down required. And if you're poor, then half a page is only $180. All right, come on, come on. Thursday, December 7th, the Apopka High School Music Department presents the Winter Holiday Concert, featuring the Brass Choir, Concert Band, Symphonic Band, and Jazz Band. This spectacular event will take place on the AHS Main Campus Auditorium at 7:30. Admission is free, however, donations will be gladly accepted for Toys R Tots. The music performed will range from traditional holiday tunes to world music to carols that really swing.
Good morning. I'm Coach King, the athletic director. First, I'd like to congratulate the football team on an excellent season just completed. You brought a lot of pride back to the high school. Now I'd like to invite all of our student body to come out and support our winter sports. All of our winter sports are in full season now. This has been a great first week. Our boys soccer team won 1-0 Wednesday night on a late goal. Our girls soccer team has won 2 games this week. Our wrestling team tied Winter Park in their opening meet Wednesday night. They have a home meet tonight here at starting at 6:30. Our boys soccer team play here tonight against University. Our girls basketball teams won 2 games this week, including a 1-point thriller last night. They play at home again on Saturday night. Our boys basketball team won in a tournament at Lyman last night, They play again at 5:30 Saturday. So let's get out and support our winter sports. We've got a lot of activities going on. Please come out and support them. I would like to remind you all that I have a student pass available for $35 that'll get you into all of our regular season home events. It's a great savings, so if you need a student pass, come see me. So I'll be placing an order next week for Letterman's jackets. Anybody who would like to order a Letterman's jacket, come see me in the front commons. Also, now I need the help of all of our students and our athletes. Last weekend, someone broke into all of our athletic buildings on the outside of the school. They stole about $1,500 worth of equipment. They stole paint. They painted up rooms. They broke into ticket office, baseball concession, paint room, coach's office. Everything that the athletic department has is raised by ticket sales or by the athletes themselves going out and raising the money. Every penny that we have to repeat spend is just something else that is denied our athletes. So if anybody on this campus knows anything about the break-in last week, I would encourage you to stop by and talk to one of the administrators and help us solve and eliminate this kind of problem, because it's a real problem. Again, come out and support our Blue Darters. See you at a game. Thank you.
My name is Ryan Rutledge.
And I'm Elisa Kepler.
And SGA is sponsoring Toys for Tots again this year, starting on November 29th.
Through December 13th.
We're also doing a class competition through certain first period teachers.
We're also having a competition between each class, seniors, juniors, sophomores, and freshmen.
If you guys could bring in your new and used toys or loose change, we would really appreciate it.
Thanks.
Santa's little helper.
Attention, the boys' basketball team defeated Lake Mary 61-45. Reed Nelson led all scores with 17 points. Earl Clayton had an awesome game with 16 points. And Brett Finney chipped in with the 9 points. The Pop can play again at 5:30. Don't forget Saturday, okay, to go see their game. Okay. Support them.
Okay.
Zabunda.
FCA meeting, December 6th.
December 6th.
After school?
After school.
6 p.m. Possible 17.
17.
There will be free pizza and guest speaker named Tim Hancock.
Hancock. No horse flies. No
yes,
horse
yes,
flies.
Yes, yes, yes. And now, to a video.
Video.
Attention freshmen. Do you hope to graduate in 2004? To proudly walk across the AHS football field? To see your parents standing up and cheering when you finally receive that long-awaited high school diploma? Well, if you think you're on the right track to graduation, you are absolutely wrong.
That's right, freshman class of 2004. Look at this chart, guys. 61% of you guys are failing, which means you have below a 2.0. 39% of you guys are passing. Now, by the time you get to your senior year, grades are really, really hard to pull up, especially if you've done bad in your freshman year. Your freshman year can set you up for how you're going to do in the future. And I hate to tell you this, guys, but as you get into higher grades, it only gets more difficult. So you guys need to bring your grades up now while you still can and get that 2.0, so you too can be graduating by the time you guys are seniors.
Hi guys, this is Apopka Varsity Soccer. We have a game tonight versus University. Varsity plays at 7, JV's at 5:30.
Guys, please come and support us. We need you all the support we need. Please come and support your soccer team. Thanks.
Checking into leaving, yeah, I'm folding. I'm tired of breaking down and shaking this life around. I'm tired of praying.
I'm here with Coach Darlington. Coach, how do you think your season went this year?
It was a good season. Yeah, we came out, won district championship, made the playoffs for the first time since 94, won the school's first playoff game in history without Jeremy Rudolph. with a young team. Had a great group of 12 seniors, but we're very much a junior team, so we kind of hope to even be better next year. You know, one of the...
As the king of Zamunda, I want to show my gracious gratitude to the people of the Apopka High School for inviting us from all the way from Zamunda.
Zamunda!
Oh, we love it here, we love it here.
Yes, yes. We might come back one day, but it's time for us to go.
Time to go.
Oliver, our servant, Amagogo, make sure you get on the plane by 5 o'clock today or you're stuck
o'clock.
In America.
In America, don't want to do that.
Okay, thank you.
Okay.
Goodbye.
Come to Zamunda, have a goat feast.
Goat feast.
Goat feast.
Goat feast.
Good goat.
Good goat.
Welcome to the DNN.
I'm Stephanie.
And I'm Tara.
There will be a meeting for all boys interested in playing water polo Wednesday after school in Mr. Russell's room, portable 2, on the main campus.
And now to headlines.
5th, and there is 26 days left in the year.
Today in history, in 1901, the movie producer and theme park visionary Walt Disney was born in Chicago. Also in 1792, George Washington was re-elected as president.
In the news today, Al Gore, unable to persuade a Tallahassee judge to recount 14,000 ballots, has returned to the Florida Supreme Court in one more desperate bid to jumpstart the ballot counting and give him a chance to defeat George Bush.
In the world, Endeavour's crew slowly unfurled the huge left solar wing on Space Station Alpha using a start and stop procedure.
In local news, Umatilla is now housing a pair of extremely rare white Bengal tigers. They were born Monday morning at the Exotic Education Center outside of Umatilla.
And remember, there are only 20 days left to shop until Christmas, so get out there and get your Christmas presents.
This has been Ryan.
And Jillian.
And now back to Christian.
Attention all junior class council members. There will be a meeting this Tuesday, December 5th. Please plan to attend. There is also an FCA meeting this Tuesday, December 6th, whatever that is, at 6 p.m. in Portable 17. There will be a free pizza and a guest speaker by the name of Tim Hancock. And now to a video.
Water. Shops of sweet water. Victoria's Restaurant.
This is Victoria's. You can eat here. Let's go take a look.
Business hours, Monday 11 to 10, Tuesday 11 to 10, Wednesday 11 to 10, Thursday 11 to 10, Sunday 4 to 10, Italian food, oh yeah baby.
Chicken wings are mad good too, 10 chicken wings for only $4.95.
Alright, good video host Way. Attention, National Spanish Honor Society members. Remember that Tuesday, December 5th is our Christmas party in Miss Moore's room. Remember to bring your items you signed up for. There will be music, drinks, and party flavors provided. Also, if you haven't paid your dues, this is your last opportunity. Gracias. All right, last night, the Apopka girls soccer team defeated Lyman 2-1. KK Ingram scored the two first half goals with Brittany Jones assisting in one of the goals. The win gives the team a 7-1 record, and the Lady Dollars play Dr. Phillips tonight, a very important district game. Game time is 7 p.m. Be there. All right, now to just read a video.
Read my favorite book, which is Shogun. It might be long, but it's a real good book. Now let's go check out and see what Samantha Meyer's favorite book is.
My favorite book so far this year is Memoirs of a Geisha by Arthur Bolton.
Yeah.
As of Friday, Miss Bolton was in the lead for the Toys for Tots drive with almost $80, and Miss Christy West was in second place. Looks like those ninth grade teachers need some competition from the main campus. You may either give to your grade level can at lunch or your favorite teacher until December 13th.
Cans will be going around at lunch for each class. Be sure to give all your loose change to Toys for Tots. All the money will be used to buy toys for the Head Start program. Thanks, SGA.
And Thursday, December 7th, the Apopka High School Music Department presents Winter Holiday Concert. This event will take place in the AHS Main Campus Auditorium at 7:30 p.m. Admission is free, however, donations will be gladly accepted. Thank you. And now to Adam's video.
Hi, I'm Adam Law, and I'm right outside Panera Bread from Belmont Springs, so let's go inside and take a look. This has been Adam Law at the Panera Bread of Altamont Springs. Stop by sometime.
Attention National Honor Society, or Arts Honor Society members. Stop by Mrs. Elliott's room to pick up your packet for carnation sale and your permission slip for December 15th. And now to a read a book video.
Probably my favorite book of all time is Gone with the Wind. I read it probably 15 years ago, but it stays with me. It's very poignant and covers all the bases that you want in a good novel. Cut it, I gotta answer the phone.
Hey, Playlock! Wake up! What are you doing? Just sleeping?
No, I was reading my favorite book, Stephen King's The Green Mile.
Well, remember, just read. Don't sleep.
Beta Club members, candy cane sales will be finishing this week and money and completed forms must be turned in to Mr. Camp no later than Monday, December 11th. Also, don't forget, we will make the canes Monday through Wednesday in Mr. Camp's room. Wednesday is the December meeting and we will have pizza. Apopka High School students, if you want to buy a candy cane reindeer with a message for someone, see a Beta Club member. They are only 50 cents and they are very cute.
To all new hire and Universal Studios employees, the first day of orientation will be Tuesday, December 12th from 2:30 to 6 p.m. in the AHS Auditorium. Please bring two forms of identification, and the second day of orientation is also already scheduled. Please see Jamisha Campbell or Marguita Outlaw for more details. Remember, both orientation days are mandatory for the seasonal job. Sorry about those names.
And now to a video.
My favorite book is The Rapture of Canaan by Sherry Reynolds. It's a really good book. And now we're going to see what Miss Orton's favorite book is.
It's called The Horse Goddesses by Morgan Llewellyn. She writes about the history of Ireland. And The Horse Goddess is about the Celtic goddess of the horse and how it's a legend of how the Celts got the horse from the Scythians in ancient European history.
And now we're going to go to another
read a book video.
Hi, I'm just looking for a book to read. Like, you know what my favorite book is? Jurassic Park. Yep, they made it into a movie and it was pretty good in 93, that's when it came out. But I like it because it talks about new scientific achievements and what they've done with it, and they brought dinosaurs back. You should read it.
Macintosh, my favorite book, which I'm reading right now, actually, I'm about halfway through, is Atlas Shrugged by Ayn Rand. And I just like it because it deals with a lot of really deep issues just about life and the world and how if you work really hard and you make a lot of creations within the world and how you see how people react to that and how different groups react. Not really sure how it ends because I'm not finished with it, but it's very, very recommended reading. And I think one of the English classes this year is reading The Fountainhead by the same author, which is very good as well.
Kurt's house, and
So how much time does it require to have a house like this?
It's on and off during the week, but you know, you're looking at probably a week.
A week? That's a lot of time. So what's your favorite part about your Christmas lights?
I really enjoy putting them up, you know, to share it with everybody else, and fortunate enough to, you know, be able to, you know, have the time to do it, mm-hmm. you know, for the kids and adults.
And what's your least favorite part about it?
When it comes time to take them down,
yeah.
putting them up's fun, but taking them down, you know, yeah. you don't have the enthusiasm, you know, yeah. the same as you're putting them up.
Well, that's been all for Kurt's house, and bye.
We've got approximately 25 to 30,000 lights. I'm probably about 85% done. Still have reindeer, Santa Claus, and, you know, the normal to do yet. A lot more track lighting on the sidewalk. But I'm happy with it so far, and hopefully everybody can enjoy it.
Good morning, Apopka. Welcome to DNN. I'm Tara.
And I'm Stephanie.
Hey, if you guys are bored over the winter break, go see a movie. These movies come out this week. What Women Want, guys, you should go see this one. Emperor's New Car, or New Groove, and Dude, Where's My Car?
And now the headlines.
Dude!
Sweet! Well, today is Friday, December 15th, and you have 10 more days until Christmas. Today in headlines, after a young couple died in a crash, the grandparents of their brain-damaged son began a tug-of-war for him. All three grandparents agree that the 11-pound, 3-month-old responds to music and calms down when held. He was delivered 30 minutes after his mother died. Also, health plans must cover birth control and federal agencies has. The decision was implications for millions of women whose plans exclude prescription contraceptives. And today's weather should be a breeze with a high of 82 and a low of 63.
And in other news, Gail's birthday is coming up. It is the big 65. This makes him eligible for senior health care and gives him a $2 discount at the local theater. So if you see him today, tell him he looks good for going over the hill 4 times. Happy birthday to Scale.
Tomorrow.
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 And now the restaurant review.
Raleigh Stewart, and I'm here doing my restaurant review at the famous Kathy's Wings and Sub. Getting it done down. Let's go inside and take a look. All right, feel me. How you want the wings? Our wings. Mild. Medium.
Hot. Extra hot.
Extra. Extra hot.
Extra.
Extra. Extra hot.
Garlic, the camera, but
barbecue. Light. Honey. Mustard. Lemon. Pepper.
Shut up!
Y'all need to come on down here to Kathy's.
You want to go to Kathy's?
Okay, I'm down to Kathy's.
Kathy's!
Alright, this is your boy Raleigh's support from Kathy's Wings and Sub. Good grub all day long. I'm on Hawaii. It's on Hawaii, so come on up here and y'all come get full like I did.
Don't forget about exams next week. Monday is 3rd and 6th, Tuesday 2nd and 5th, and Wednesday is 1st and 4th.
Monday is a regular day, and Tuesday and Wednesday you get out at noon.
And don't forget to study, study, study. And now back to Maine.
A big congratulations goes to Miss Bolton's classes for collecting the most toys for tots money. Their total was over $575. The juniors were in the big class, were the big class winners with $309. In all, over $2,000 was raised for toys for tots in this area for children in need. Thanks a lot.
I just want to take this time to apologize to my best friend. Dave, I'm sorry I messed up. Please forgive me. I love you. And now to video.
Thank you.
Connectors on 436 in Altamont Springs. I am here bringing you another restaurant review. Peanut butter and banana is my favorite for only $2.75. Nectar's has everything. Juices, healthy food, and awesome smoothies. Everyone should come here. It's a great place to eat and it has decent prices. This has been Stephanie reporting for DNN.
Oh, what's up, everybody?
What's up, everybody?
This is Santa Claus number one.
Santa Claus number
and
one.
Santa Claus number two.
Santa Claus number two.
We just want to tell y'all something.
I'm going to tell y'all.
See, a lot of y'all done been naughty.
Naughty.
You see, you ain't been coming to school.
On the bad list.
They get your 3 points.
3 points.
Y'all got to be on time.
3 points.
Because you can't be tardy.
Can't be tardy.
You can't be absent.
Can't be absent.
You got to be on time.
Can't be late.
Tell your neighbor, say on time.
On time.
On time.
On time.
On time.
On time.
On time. On time. On time, you gotta be on time.
Be on time.
Not in my boy Wayne head. Oh, Wayne head. Wow.
What's up, Apopka? This Wayne head.
This ain't Bo.
We out here trying to send a message to y'all. Come out to see our boys for Apopka Blue Dodgers play against the Doc Phillips Panthers tonight. With a triple header, the freshman play at 4:30, JV play at 6, and varsity play at 7:30. We hope to see y'all there, and we want to send a message to them 3-0 boys to come out there and represent y'all.
Represent, come on.
Good morning, Apopka. I'm here at 536 West Churchill Station at a local restaurant that I'm filming, Gossip's Caribbean Restaurant. Let's go inside and take a look around. Let's go take a look, guys. Come on. Pretty tight. They got a little waterfall and everything going on. You'll be like, I'm in the islands already. They got Jamaican pat on the beef patty. You know, I'm gonna go ahead and go take myself a little seat and get my little menu board and see what's going on, alright? Yeah, I'm in Gossip right now. Just been seated, checking out the menu. Got some good things like beef patties only for $1. Not school beef patties, real beef patties. It's like this Jamaican restaurant. Yeah, they got roti, curry goat, curry shrimp, curry beef, roti. Oh, this place looks good. So I'm gonna get myself some food. You guys, just welcome. Look around. Looks like a Jamaican atmosphere. Check out the walls and stuff. Just place my order. I'm not really that hungry, so I'm just gonna go with like a Jamaican beef patty. So, wait for the order. Chill. Indulge in a nice warm Jamaican beef patty, washing it down with an imported Jamaican drink, D&G pineapple soda. It tastes just like that. Right now we're looking at a plate of stewed chicken and a plate of curry chicken. That looks real good, but I'm not that hungry. And some plantains in the back.
Vegetables.
Yeah. It's real good. Beverages, like these squeezers. And here we have a D&G tin, imported. It's grapefruit soda. Here we have pineapple, so I'll drink it back there. Here we have cream soda, ginger beer, cola champagne, which is very, very highly recommended drink that you should try when you come to Gossip's restaurant. And the Vitamalt, some more other Caribbean drinks. Here at a local restaurant, it's real good, cheap prices, less space to come, great background, great people, great atmosphere, great food.
You guys remember to go down your exam. There are only 10 days left until Christmas, so if you haven't finished all your shopping, hurry up.
And there are 16 days left until the year 2001. Seniors, there are only about 5 more months till graduation. Woo!
Oh yeah! Jingle bell time! Jingle bell time! Jingle bell time! Jingle bell time!
Jingle bells!
Jingle bells! Jingle bells!
Good morning, Apopka. Welcome to another edition of the DNN. I'm Trisha.
And I'm Chrissy.
Attention football players. Off-season workouts begin Monday, January 8th at 2:15. There will be a weekends meeting Tuesday, January 9th in the Family Service Center after school.
Softball conditioning resumes today at the softball field at 2:30. All girls who plan on playing fast pitch softball should be there. Thanks, Coach McWithy.
Now to Tara for headlines.
Scarves, gloves, coats, and sweaters should be worn today with a low at 29 degrees, but it may get as warm as 63 degrees by later today. All of you that are fans of the old Survivor show can rest easy. The cast of Survivor 2 has been announced. The show debuts January 28th after the Super Bowl. Florida State universities can expect nearly $100 million this year in direct federal funding. That's a 50% increase from last year. University of South Florida will get the most, totaling around $40 million. And scientists have developed a gel that temporarily stops hair from growing. This has been used in chemotherapy patients to prevent them from going bald. And now back to Maine.
Attention all National Spanish Honor Society members. There will be a meeting on Tuesday, January 9th in room 2 p.m. in room 10. Attendance is mandatory. We will be talking about sweatshirts and volunteer service. Please make sure you attend. Gracias, Senora Mora.
All seniors and juniors who wish to take the ACT on February 10th are reminded to stop by the attendance office and pick up an ACT form. You must meet the deadline January 5th to avoid a late fee. Seventh period classes will begin on Monday, January 8th. Report to that class in order to register for this class. Remember, you must have your own transportation, and once the classes begin, you may not drop it. The following classes will be offered. First semester of Algebra 1B in room 204. First semester of American History in Portable 6. First semester of English 2 in room 814. HSCT Communication Preparations in Portable 6, Earth Science in the Science Building in room 106, and American Government in room 200.
Attention all junior class members. There will be a junior class meeting Wednesday, January 10th in Ms. Albertson's classroom. Plan to stay for 45 minutes.
Relay for Life. Attention all clubs and teams. Plan to join our Relay for Life event this year. Form a 15-member team and pay $100 to the American Cancer Society. Then pledge to raise $100 per team member. For those of you who can't do math, that's $1,500 per team. See Coach Smolin and ROCT for questions. This is a chance to help out in the fight against cancer. Thanks.
And now to Ryan.
Good morning, Apopka. Yesterday we started our Get Out of Apopka videos, and today I'm going to take you guys to International Drive. Check out Skull Kingdom. It's a local spot down on International Drive, so here's my video.
Good morning, Apopka. My name is Ryan Monroe. Right now I'm standing outside of Skull Kingdom, located on International Drive, right across the street from Wet n' Wild. So let's go inside, take a look, and see what they got. I think it might be a little bit of spooky, but we never know, so let's go check it out.
Elephant, Skull Kingdom.
Hi! How are you?
I'm all right.
You smell like Old Spice.
Really?
You gotta go look. It's Skull Kingdom.
It's Skull Kingdom.
Look, it's Skull Kingdom.
Look at camera now. Look at camera. Do your job. It's pretty incredible. So you like the job here? Actually, what is your job here?
Oh, it's my turn.
Yeah.
Ah! Your turn! That is my turn! Okay, how do you like your job? Are you a reporter?
Yep.
Are you a reporter?
Reporter.
What station?
DNN.
I never heard of that.
It's Star News Network.
You must not be very good.
Yeah,
you're so-so? Uh-huh. Wait a minute, if you're not very good, what does it say about the people watching you?
People that love me.
They love you? Okay, well, ask your questions then.
Alright, so what's your job here at Skull Kingdom?
My job at Skull Kingdom is to mop and greet the people when they come in. Because I'm very personable.
Okay.
I know social graces.
Really?
I know them really well. I'm very, very sociable. So I greet people.
Ask about Skull Kingdom.
Skull Kingdom!
Come see the
kid. It's Skull Kingdom. It's Christian's elf. He's got to talk louder. Talk over me. Go. You can do it.
Skull Kingdom.
Christian's elf. Christian's elf.
Outside of the lobby, looks a little spooky on top of a coffin. But I already paid my ticket, and we're just about to go in. I'm just waiting for a little bit, so just sit back and chill.
The Skull Kingdom's mazes. Looks pretty spooky. Sorry, turn on the light. What do you mean the light's not working? Yeah, let's go on anyway. You guys heard that noise over there?
Ah! What was that?
Oh crap. Time to get out of here. I can't handle this. I'm black. Time to go. I need to leave.
Oh! What was that?
Gotcha.
Ah!
Skull King, this was scary. Y'all come out. It's real cheap. Real fun. I'm gonna go home and take my heart medicine. I'll see y'all later.
Attention French Club, there is a mandatory French Club meeting Monday the 8th after school. See Ms. Harris for further details.
Attention all French Club students going to the Barcelona-Paris French trip in 2002. New candy will be arriving this Monday the 8th. If you don't catch Ms. Harris during a period, get your candy after school during the French Club.
There is a talent show audition open to everyone on the freshman campus in the cafetorium on January 8th. It is sponsored by the Freshman Class Council.
Congratulations to the men's soccer team for defeating West Orange 2-1 in a district matchup. With this victory, Apopka swept West Orange for the district matchup. Goals for the Darters were scored by Mark Goularte and Kyle Simolin. Assists were by Jeff Blackman and Stuart Lulis. Outstanding games were played by senior Shaw and Carlos Alvarado, junior Amrit Patel, and sophomore Ryan Bright and Hunter Hodges. Apopka's next game will be against Edgewater this Friday.
All junior class members, there will be a meeting on January 9th. All members must come.
This has been All for the DNN. I'm Chrissy.
And I'm Trish. I hope everybody see everybody at the basketball and soccer games tonight.
Bye. Bye.
Good morning, Apopka. Welcome to the DNN. I'm Amy.
And I'm Emily.
Today is January 9th, year 2001. And now to Sean with the headlines.
Good morning, students. There are 356 days left till the year 2002. This day, in 1788, Connecticut became the fifth state to ratify the Constitution. And in other news, members of a state task force said the punch card voting system should bite the dust before 2002. Today's weather is going to be sunny but cool with a high of 56 and a low of 33. And now to Teddy Bear Tara.
Thanks, Sean. Hi, I'm Tara Lutz, and for my Get Out of Apopka video, I did a Sky Ventures, a simulated skydiving adventure. So I hope you enjoy it. I'm Tara Lutz here reporting for the DNN, and as you can see, it's really windy out here, and with this 120 mile an hour wind tunnel behind me, it doesn't help very much. We're here at Sky Venture down on iDrive, and we're just going to go in and take a look and see what it's all about.
It's a great pleasure. It's a great, great pleasure. It's a great pleasure to have all of you here today. I thought you all might begin your tour here.
I recommend everybody go out there and do it. And when you're done through all the training and you fly, you have this, get this little certificate that verifies that you've flown. And that's about all. So go out there, try it. You have the adventures of skydiving without all the risk of dying.
The Thurgood Marshall Society, formerly McKnight Achiever Society, is a community-based program designed to give recognition to African-American students in grades 4th through 12th who excel academically. This organization is limited to select high achievers. If you made at least 2 A's and no grades lower than a B this past semester, you are eligible to apply to this prestigious organization. Applicants who provide documentation of a complete community service project will be given priority in the application process. The deadline to apply is Friday, January 26, 2001. Bring your current report card to room 134 on the main campus to acquire an application. Remember, acceptance to this organization is limited.
Auditions for the spring musical, The Music Man, are this week, Thursday, January 11th. For additional information and to sign up for an additional block, go to the main campus chorus room. The Music Man is a huge, high-energy production with a large cast. There are singing and non-singing roles and lots of dancers. This is the chorus department's 10th musical, and it is going to be awesome. See Mrs. Boot if you have any questions.
Attention all JV and varsity bowlers from the season just completed. There will be a short meeting this Thursday, January 11th, in Coach L. Camp's room immediately after school. Please be there to see Coach Camp if you want to be in the yearbook photo.
Attention Latin Club members, there will be a mandatory meeting Thursday, January 18th, immediately after school in room 306. Plan on staying an hour. Snacks will be provided, but bring your own drink. Fundraising candy will be distributed and spring projects discussed. All members are required to sell candy. If you cannot attend the meeting, you must see Mrs. Grabowski prior to January 18th.
Attention National Art Honor Society members, there is a meeting in room 406 Thursday, January 11th. Be there so you can get your pass for the club picture. There will also be business to take care of.
Attention all seniors, cap and gown sales run through February 7th, 8th, and 9th. Also, senior class council meeting directly after school, January 9th. This is a mandatory meeting. Thanks.
And now to a WWW segment.
Good morning, Apopka. This year we have been forced to do a WWW segment.
Ever wonder what time it is in Africa? China? Russia? Haiti? China? Neither have I. But I've got a site here so you can find out what time it is in Russia, China, and all those other great places. It is www.globalmetric.com/time. It is a great place to look up sites and look up times around the world. And now back to Maine.
Attention all National Spanish Honor Society members. There will be a meeting on Tuesday, January 9th at 2:10 p.m. in room 705. Attendance is mandatory. We will be talking about our sweatshirts and our volunteer project, as well as senior courts. Please make sure you attend. Gracias, Senior Moore.
All Darter Club members, there will be a meeting this Thursday, January 11th, after school in Miss Doyle's room.
Relay for Life. Attention all clubs and teams. Plan to join in our Relay for Life event this year. Form a 15-member team and pay $100 to the American Cancer Society. Then pledge to raise $100 per team member. Per team. See Colonel Smolin in ROTC for questions.
All junior class members, there will be a meeting on January 10th. All members must come.
The regular meeting of the Beta Club will be this Wednesday, January 10th, in the cafetorium at 1:20. Please plan on attending. This has been all for the DNN. I'm Amy.
And I'm Emily. Bye.
Have a good day.
Good morning, Apopka, and welcome to another edition of DNN. I'm Chad.
And I'm Roy.
The Thurgood Marshall Society, designed to give recognition to African-American students in grades 4 to 12. If you made at least two A's and no grade lower than a B this past semester, you're eligible to apply to this prestigious organization. The deadline to apply is Friday, January 26th, 2001. Bring your current report card to room 134 on the main campus to acquire an application.
FCA will be having a meeting in room 205 Tuesday the 16th. Donuts will be served.
And now to headlines.
Today is the 12th day of 2001, and there are 353 days left in the year. Today in history, in 1932, Hattie W. Carraway became the first woman elected into U.S. Senate. You go, girl. Today in headlines, AOL and Time Warner got the final okay to proceed with their massive merge. And for all you house buyers out there, mortgage rates went down 7 big percent to the lowest 20. It's the lowest in 21 months. And President-elect Bush has filled his cabinet slates with choices of Elaine Chao for Labor and Robert Zoellick for U.S. Trade. And happy birthday to the amazing Kreskin. I'm seeing that he's 66 and that Tony Hawk is going to be skating at Universal City Walk at Saturday, like my
using psychic skills, and now to Maine.
Relay for Life. Attention all clubs and teams. Plan to join in our Relay for Life event this year. Form a 15-member team and pay $100 to the American Cancer Society. Then pledge to raise $100 per team member per team. See Colonel Smolin in ROTC for questions.
Attention National Art and Honor Society members. There will be a meeting in room 406 Thursday, January 11th. Be there so you can get your pass for the club pictures. There will also be business to take care of.
Attention all swimmers who order team pictures. Please come to pick them up from Coach Orton's room on the main campus.
Hey, Apopka, I'm Stephanie.
And I'm Jillian.
And we filmed our Get Out of Apopka segment at
Downtown Disney, where you can shop, eat, and hang out.
And after our segment, we'll be going back to our wonderful, calm main anchors.
And now to our video.
In front of the 12 Days of Christmas, where it's Christmas all year round. Let's go inside and see what's there. In front of the Rainforest Cafe, one of the greatest places to eat down here. Legoland. Have you ever heard of Apopka? Apopka.
I think he's sleeping, Stephanie.
Go. Hello? That's a nice plane you got there, buddy.
I can take that picture for you, miss.
Hello?
Miss?
Nice baby you got there.
Stephanie,
I'm choking on my microphone cord. Hey, have you ever heard of Apopka? Apopka! Apopka? No, guess not.
There will be a club love meeting on Tuesday, January 16th in room 135 immediately after school.
Attention swimmers, passes for your yearbook pictures are now available. Coach Russell has the passes for the boys' passes, and Coach Orton has the passes for the girls. Come pick them up as soon as possible.
Callbacks for the Music Man will be Tuesday, January 16th at 7:30 p.m. The callback list will be posted on the outside chorus room door Saturday morning at 10 a.m.
Didn't do so well last summer? Afraid you might not graduate or pass? Need help studying for the HSCT? Get help at Farm Workers Affairs in 815 South Park Avenue. When? Every Monday and Wednesday until after school. Transportation from the school is guaranteed. Transportation home can be provided if necessary. That's all for the DNN. See you tomorrow.
Tomorrow is the weekend.
No, well then Monday.
Apopka High School. I'm Kel Duncan.
And I'm Kevin Borge, and today is January 17, 2001.
Attention! All students interested in playing water polo must get their physicals into Coach Rolson this week. Practice starts next Monday in Mount Door Pool.
The AR program and circulation are back up, running in the Media Center. Now for headlines.
Hello, Apopka. Today is Tuesday, January 16th, and you have 349 more days until the year 2002. Today in history, in 1964, the musical Hello Dolly opened on Broadway. And in headlines, in El Salvador, the death toll rose above 600 on Monday in an earthquake that sparked landslides across El Salvador and Central America. And as the water threat at landfire looms in the St. John's River Water the St. John's Water Management District is cracking down on lawn watering. And in sports, the New York Knicks forward Marcus Camby threw a fist at an opposing player, but ended up bumping heads with his coach, Jeff Van Gundy. Jeff Van Gundy is requiring stitches for the cut above his eye. And now to announce, students who did not earn a 3.6 or higher weighted GPA in the first 9 weeks can still apply for honors letter bar if they have earned a 3.6 GPA in the second 9 weeks and foresee a 3.6 GPA being earned in the third 9 weeks. Applications can be picked up in Ms. Soto's science room, 217, and in the front officer guidance. Copies of the report card application need to be turned in by Friday, January 29th, 2001, in the same locations. Any questions, see Ms. Soto. And now to Grandmaster Steve.
Yo, yo, now some old school flavor for you right here. I'll make the groove, I just want y'all to move, so just wave your hands in the air. Wave them like you just don't care. I just want y'all to know that I got the flow. I know I'm white, but that's aight. My name's Steven C, and I'm on the DNN, that's where I be. I gotta get out a video for a Apopka video for you to see. It's a place I like to call Kobe. Alright.
I am Stephen Clinney, reporting from 436 in Altamonte Springs by beautiful Altamonte River. Look at that beautiful river. It is so beautiful. Now, there are many, many places for you to go to down here in this hood. But right now, I will show you one of my favorite places to go. No, I know what you're thinking. It is not Trappy Grill. But it is called Kobe's. Kobe Japanese Takeout opens 7 days a week from 5 p.m. to 10 p.m. You can go to Kobe's and be amazed at what our chefs can do with shiny, sharp objects. You can come visit our fresh sushi bar, open from 5 p.m. to 10 p.m. Come and see what we can do with the match and your dinner. Come and be dumbfounded by the theme. Be stupefied as we show you how to cut vegetables the ancient Japanese way. And watch as we sharpen our knives. And watch our basketball skills. Yeah, yeah, yeah. And watch us cook at your table. Looking at my notes, I see Kobe have many other locations in Orlando, so if you'd like to be amazed at our Japanese skills for a sensible price, come. Tell them DNN sent you. I'm Stephen Clinton reporting. Bye.
Would you like to know someone's birthday who is famous? Go to www.famousbirthdays.com. And Kid Rock's birthday is tomorrow.
Relay for Life, attention all clubs and teams, plan to join in our Relay for Life event this year. Form a 15-member team and pay $100 to the American Cancer Society. Then pledge to raise $100 per team member. See Colonel Simon in ROTC for questions. This is our chance to help in the fight against cancer. Relay for Life will be held on our football field March 23rd to the 24th.
Hey, didn't do so well last semester? Afraid you might not graduate or pass? Need help studying for the HSE? We'll get tutoring. We're the Office of Farm Workers and Affairs, 815 South Park Avenue, Apopka, Florida, 32703. When? Every Monday and Wednesday, after school until 6 on Monday and 5 on Wednesday. Transportation from the school to the office is granted. Transportation home after tutoring is provided if necessary. If interested, have questions, or want more information, talk to Patrick or John, your America Corps volunteers. Give your name to Miss Sasser or Miss Berlin, or call 407-886-5151.
Attention all swimmers who order team pictures. Please come pick them up in Coach Orton's room on the main campus.
There will be a FCA meeting today in room 205, and donuts will be served. So come get some. Well, that's been all for this edition of DNN.
Till next time.
Bye. Bye.
What's up, Apopka High School? I'm Avidor, and this is...
Andrew. Your school counselors invite you to join in celebrating this week by listening to Something to Think About each day during our morning announcements. As National School Counseling Week comes to a close, we hope that you remember these words. Leave this world a little bit better than you found it. What can you do today to make that true at our school, at home, in our community?
Now to Stephanie with headlines.
Today is Friday, January 26th, and there are approximately 5 hours left until the weekend officially begins. There has been an earthquake in India last night that registered a 7.9 on the Richter scale. We will now go to Sean reporting from India. Sean?
Thank you, Stephanie. As you can see, the center of the earthquake is pinpointed in Karachi. New Delhi is over 600 miles away, but there have been reports of aftershock waves in New Delhi. And now, back to Stephanie in the headlines.
And in other news, our ex-president, Mr. Bill Clinton, took all of the W's off the keyboards in Air Force One, hence George W. Bush. And now to your local weather report with Sean.
Thank you, Stephanie, and I'm Sean, the weatherman that knows where to point and what time it is. Okay, today there's a high of 65 and a low of 36. On Saturday, it's going to get a little warmer with a high of 70 and a low of 43. Sunday is going to get even a little warmer, but it's going to be a little foggy throughout the day with a high of 73 and a low of 47. And on Monday and Tuesday, it's going to be the perfect temperature for our water polo players. Go Apopka! And now back to Stephanie and the headlines.
This has been Stephanie and Sean with headlines, and now to the news.
What's up? I'm back. There will be a Club Dove meeting on Monday, January 29th in room 135, immediately after school. All students of Apopka High School are invited. Attend. Please be prompt.
There will be a Beta Club officers meeting on Wednesday, January 31st. Please be there if you are an officer.
Carnation sales on February 8th, so buy one for your sweetheart before it's too late.
Attention all clubs and teams. Plan to join our Relay for Life event this year. Form a 15-member team and pay $100 to the American Cancer Society. Then, pledge to raise $100 per team member. That's $1,500 per team. See Colonel Simolin in ROTC for questions. This is our chance to help in the fight against cancer. Relay for Life will be held on our football field March 23rd and 24th. And now to a special story.
Hi, my name's Michelle, and my special story is on a golf place.
Hey, I like golf.
And now to my special story.
Hello, Apopka. I'm here to tell you about the golf. Liquidator store. Now, this is the best store on I-Drive to buy golf equipment. In that matter, it's the best place to buy golf equipment because they're going out of business.
This, save.
Store closing,
everything.
Buy one, get one free. Clubs, drivers, putters, everything. Let's go take a look.
No big deal.
As you can see, they have golf balls for $16, a whole pack. Buy one, get one free on all the drivers.
Right now?
They also have putters. And they also have extra large golfer apparel for those of you who like to dress golf. And they have golfer shorts for those of you who like the plaid style. Golf Outlet not only sells clubs and shirts, they sell the shoes. Now this is a set of golf clubs for $50, a whole set of clubs with a bag, $50. Come on down. They also carry Tiger Woods line.
Teachers and students, please plan to donate blood at our next blood drive, Tuesday, January 30th. The Bloodmobile will be here from 8 a.m. to 2 p.m. at the Family Service Center. Students, in order to donate blood, you must be at least 17 years old. Please sign up during your lunch shift in the back commons or see Ms. Tingley before or after school. Teachers and staff do not need to sign up. Just come to the Family Service Center between 8 a.m. and 2 p.m. on Tuesday, January 30th.
On February 3rd, 2001, the UCF College Reach Out program will be hosting the fourth annual Set Up and Reach Out High School Step Extravaganza. This event will take place in the UCF Student Center Auditorium at 7 p.m. Tickets are just $7. And if you need more information, or if you're dumb and interested in stepping in the show, contact 407-823-5580.
Attention, all Florida Future educators. Please stop by or contact Ms. Bolton today. We are planning a field trip and must turn in names today. All FFEA members need to contact Ms. Bolton by the end of the day.
All students who have earned a 3.6 or higher weighted GPA for the second 9 weeks grading period and have applied for the honors letter or bar need to turn in a copy of the report card to Ms. Soto. Science room 217 or the front office or guidance office by today. Today is the last day, so turn it in.
Well, that's been all for the DNN today. This is Andrew. And
this is Avidor.
Hope you all have a great day.
Yeah, bye.